So today we will be discussing the next part of the 8085 programming, in which we will be discussing about the sorting of the number, whether it will be ascending order or descending order. Now, before that, we have already learned about how to find out the largest number out of the series of the number which is given. And today, we will be discussing about the sorting of the number. So the problem statement says that we have to write a program to sort given 10 numbers, which are stored at the memory location 8050H. And what we have to do, we have to sort this number in the ascending order. Ascending order, first of all, we have to learn about what do you mean by ascending order. Ascending order means whenever we are going to sort in the ascending order, the lowest number will be the first number and the highest number will be the last number. It means in the increasing order, upon the magnitude of the data, the number should be arranged in the increasing order. So we have to adopt a technique by which we can do the sorting. We have already learned that a lot of techniques are available for sorting of the number. Whenever we have to do this sorting of the number manually, so we will look the individual number, try to find out which one is the smallest number, and the smallest number to be picked and to be put first. Then we try to find out the second smallest number and should be placed at the second place, and so on. So in this way, we have to do the sorting by manually. Now, we have to do the sorting of the number by writing a program. And 10 numbers are given. So it means we have to do certain comparison process in between the two numbers. And whatever number is lesser to be put for in the first place. For example, these 10 numbers are given. First of all, what I will do, I will put this 79 into the accumulator. And then we try to compare this 79, which is present in the accumulator, with the second number, that is 74. And if we find that the number which is present in the accumulator is lesser than the 74, then it means it is in a sequence. But whenever we find that the content of accumulator is greater than the second number, then what we will do, we try to swap. We try to swap these two numbers so that 74 should come first and 79 should become the second. Once we are able to compare these two numbers, what will happen? Now the second number, which is placed at 8051, it should be placed in the accumulator. And then it is compared with the third number. If that number which is placed in the accumulator is lesser than 89, then it's okay, no problem. Otherwise, if the second number is greater, means 89 is lesser than the 74, then we have to swap. So what we have to do, so we have a flow chart for doing the comparison. Now, in this way, step by step, we do the comparison. We first compare these two numbers. And if the second number is lesser, it will be put first, and the second will be put as a second. Then second will be compared with the third number, and whichever number is smaller is put first. Then third number is compared with the fourth. The third, fourth will be compared with the fifth. Fifth will be compared with the sixth, and so on. So it means there, if there are 10 numbers, we have to do the 9 times comparison. And after doing this 9 time comparison, what will happen? That individual two numbers which are being compared all together, the smaller will become the first one, and the greater will become the second one. But it doesn't mean that after doing 9 comparison, it doesn't mean that the smallest number will be coming on the top. No, it's not possible. So it means after doing one round of this comparison, we have to adopt another round of comparison, because if 79 is compared with 74, 74 will come up and 79 will come down. Then 79 will be compared with 89, so 79 is, and 89 is okay. Then 89 is compared with 33, so 33 will come here and 89 will come here. Then 89 will be compared with 45, so 45 will come here, 89 will come here. 89 will be compared with 76, so 76 will come here and 89 will come here. Since 89 is lesser than 90, so it will remain as it is. Then 90 is compared with 26, so 26 will come here and 90 will come here. 90 will be compared with 88, so 88 is lesser, so 88 will come here and 90 will come here. And 90 is compared with 01, so 01 will come here and 90 will come here. So 01 is coming over here, but it is not in the ascending order still. So what we have to do after doing one round of 9 comparison, we have to go for the another round of comparison. And in, by doing this, it means we have to do 9 comparison in one round. And similarly, we have to adopt 9 rounds of comparison. Then only we are able to get this 01 over here. So what this flowchart says, that we first initialize the first counter, counter number 1, with 09, which is the indicating the number of rounds. And then we will initialize the memory pointer from where the numbers are written. And then we initialize the counter 2, you can say that as 09. Since there are 10 numbers, so there will be only 9 comparisons. Then that is why only 9 has been written. If there are 6 numbers, then you have to put the counter value as 5 and the second counter value as 5 also. So first of all, what will we will take the first number and we increment the memory pointer. And after getting the number, and we will put that number into the accumulator, incrementing the pointer, so its pointer will become 8051. And after getting 48051 as 74, so what we are going to do, we are going to check whether the pointer number 1 is greater than pointer number, pointer minus 1 is 79, means 8050, and pointer is 8051, so 79 will be compared with 74. Since this number is greater, 79 is greater than 74, so what we'll do, we will do some interchange, so that 74 will come here and 79 will come here. So if it is so, we will interchange the content. But if it is not so, here it is 74 and here it is 79, 74 is less, 79 is greater. So we will not do any kind of changes. So if pointer number 1, pointer minus 1 is not greater than pointer pointer, then it will not interchange, it will come to here. And then we will decrement this in counter by 1, increase this pointer by 1, and check whether the counter 2 has become 0 or not. All the numbers are compared or not. If it is not so, we will go back and then get the number. And now we will take the second number into the accumulator and increment the memory pointer so that it will be compared with 89. And so on. So in this way, this process will go on. And after doing this process, after 9 comparison, whatever number we are comparing two numbers, whatever numbers are smaller, it will come first, and the whatever number is greater, it will come as a second, and so on. After all this process is over, means 9 comparisons are over, then what we are going to do, we are going to decrement the counter 1. It was 9, now it will become 8, and check whether the counter 1 has become 0 or not. If it is not so, we will go back, and back again, we will have the status 5051. And so we will do this second round. First round is over. Now we'll start with the second round. And whenever we are going for second round, now we will initialize the memory pointer by 8050. We'll initialize the counter by again 9. And then we start doing the comparison again, again and again. So it means we have 9 rounds represented by counter 1. And initialize counter, a second counter is the number of comparison which is being done in one round. So it means 9 rounds, and each round contains 9 comparisons. So there are 9 into 9. 81 times comparison has been done. Then only this 01 will come on the top of the list. And once this process is over, when the counter 1 will become 0, we will come out of that and we will stop the program. And 8050 to 805A, whatever content it will be having, it will be showing the content in the ascending order. So now let us look at what is the program for that. So first of all, we have initialized the counter number 1 by 09, and we have used B register for that. HL pair is loaded with the memory pointer, that is 8050. And C register is used as a second counter as 09. We will take the first number into the accumulator. Then we will increment the memory pointer. And then we are going to compare the next number with the content of accumulator. Means pointer minus 1 is being compared with the pointer. If carry is generated, it means the accumulator content is lesser. Accumulator content is lesser, iska matlab hai, pointer minus 1 is lesser. So we will not do any kind of interchange. If 0 flag is going to set, it means both the numbers are same. Then again, we are not going to do any kind of interchange. So both the condition, it is going to skip the rest of the process, which is the process which is called the interchanging process. But if carry flag is not generated, carry flag is not set, as well as 0 flag is not set, then what we will do? We will do the interchange of the value of 8051 and between 8051 and 8050. We will put 74 here and 79 over here. And for that purpose, we have written the 5 lines. The first line says that copy the smaller number in the buffer register. Means whatever is the content of memory, that is 8051, it will be copied in the D register. And whatever is the content of A, which is the content of 8050, it will be copied in the memory. Which memory? 8051. So the content of 8051 is copied in the 8050. Then we will decrement the HL pair. HL pair is loaded right now by 8051. Now it will become 8050. Now we will copy the content of D, which is the content of 8051, into the memory. And the memory is represented by HL pair. HL pair is already decremented. So 8050 will be loaded with the content of D. And then we will increment the content of H. So the first one is the copy the smaller number in the buffer register, copy the larger number at the memory location, and then decrement the memory pointer, and then copy the buffer content into the memory. And then we are going to increment the memory pointer. And then we are going to decrement the counter number 2. And this process is going to jump on no 0 since counter number C is not 0. Previously it was 9, now it has become 8. So it is not 0, it is going to repeat. Repeat to what place? Back. Where is back? It will get the number again. And then it is going to do the same process. And after this 9 rounds, what will happen? We are going, 0 flag will be set. And then when 0 flag will be set, it will not repeat the process. It will come to the decrement P. Now in the decrement B, it is going to decrement the content of B. B is loaded with the counter number 1. So now it has become 8. Now we are going to start the second round. And the second round will start with, since decrement of B is not going to become 0, so jump on no 0 start. It will go into the start. And the process will happen as it is. And in this way, after 9 rounds, and in each round, we have 9 comparisons. So there are 81 comparisons. And after doing 81 comparisons, 8050, 8051, 8052, and last two, they will be containing the number in the ascending order. बढ़ते हुए क्रम में, राइट फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग वी विल बी हैविंग द स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर एंड देन द लार्जेस्ट. हियर अगेन आई हैव रिटन द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द सेम प्रोग्राम. 8050 is 79, 8051 is 74. So first of all, what we are doing, whatever is the content of 8050, it is loaded in the accumulator. Whatever is the content of 8051, it is the memory. Then what we are going to do, we are comparing this memory with the content of accumulator, and we find that the content of accumulator is greater. So we need certain interchange. So whenever we are starting the interchange, so what will happen? Whatever is the content of memory, it is stored in the D. That is 74 is stored in the temporary register D. And then whatever is the content of accumulator, it is copied in the memory, means 8051. So 79 will be copied in 8051. And then memory is decremented by one so that it will become 8050. And then the whatever is the content of D, that is 74, it is copied in M, that is 8050. And then memory is incremented by one so that it will become M plus one, that is 8051. And this process will go on and go on. So this is how the ascending order number is being done. Now, if you have to do the same process, if the problem statement says that instead of ascending order, you have to do it in the descending order, then what will happen? Same program will be used, same flowchart will be used, but little bit change is required. Because ascending order says बढ़ते हुए क्रम में, descending order says घटते हुए क्रम में. In ascending order, the smallest number will be the first number. In descending order, the highest number should be the first number. So this has to be taken into the account. So what will be the change in this program? The simple change is, instead of comparison, if instead of no, if I put here yes, and instead of yes, if we put no, the program will become the program for the descending order. Whatever change we have to do, instead of no, we have to write yes. Instead of yes, we have to write no. That program will be working as a descending order. And what you have to do, jump on no carry, you have to skip. Jump on no zero, you have to skip, and the program will remain as it is. Now we have another program to find out the smallest number in the block of the data. We have already discussed in the previous lecture, we have already discussed to find out the largest number. Now we are going to discuss the smallest number. Now, if you remember, अगर आपको याद होगा तो हमने हमने लार्जेस्ट नंबर पाने के लिए जो प्रोग्राम लिखा था उसमें केवल थोड़ा सा चेंज कर देंगे तो स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर का प्रोग्राम हमको मिल जाएगा. ये जो फ्लो चार्ट हमने बनाया हुआ है दैट इज मेंट फॉर द टू फाइंड आउट द नंबर विच इज द लार्जेस्ट नंबर. हम चाह रहे हैं कि स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर फाइंड आउट करें. तो स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर फाइंड आउट करने के लिए हमने यहाँ पे चार डेटा ले रखे हैं, उसको उसके अंदर हमको द स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर फाइंड आउट करना है. तो हम क्या करेंगे कि सबसे पहले जितने नंबर को एक्यूमुलेटर में वो नंबर लोड कर लेंगे सी रजिस्टर में उसको डालने के, कि कितने नंबर ऐसे हैं जिसको कि हमें जिसमें से हमको स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर फाइंड आउट करना है. एक्यूमुलेटर को हम इनिशियलाइज कर लेंगे बाय यूजिंग एक्स आर ए इंस्ट्रक्शन. एक्स आर ए इंस्ट्रक्शन मीन्स एक्सऑर ऑपरेशन विद द एक्यूमुलेटर. जो कुछ भी कंटेंट होगा पहले से एक्यूमुलेटर में उसका एक्सऑर ऑपरेशन उसी के साथ हो जाएगा और वो कंटेंट जीरो जीरो हो जाएगा, यानी क्लियर हो जाएगा एक्यूमुलेटर. अब इस केस में हम क्या करेंगे कि एक्यूमुलेटर में हम एफ एफ डाल देंगे, मैक्सिमम नंबर को डाल देंगे. लार्जेस्ट नंबर जब फाइंड आउट कर रहे थे तो हम एक्यूमुलेटर में जीरो जीरो डाल रहे थे, लेकिन जब लार्जेस्ट स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर फाइंड आउट करना होगा तो हमको एक्यूमुलेटर में हम एफ एफ डाल देंगे. अब इसके बाद हमने मेमोरी पॉइंटर को इनिशियलाइज कर दिया क्योंकि 2201 पे पहला डेटा है और पहले डेटा को हमने एक्यूमुलेटर के कंटेंट से कंपेयर किया. जब हमने एक्यूमुलेटर के कंटेंट से कंपेयर किया यानी 56 को हम कंपेयर कर रहे हैं किससे, एफएफ से, जो मैक्सिमम नंबर है। तो बड़ी नेचुरल सी बात है कि 56 स्मॉलर है, तो हम क्या करेंगे, 56 जो स्मॉलर है तो हम जब कंपेयर करेंगे तो कैरी जनरेट नहीं होगी। अगर कैरी जनरेट होगी इसका मतलब है कि एक्यूमुलेटर में स्मॉलर नंबर है, लेकिन अगर कैरी जनरेट नहीं होगी तो जो कुछ भी मेमोरी का कंटेंट है उसको हम एक्यूमुलेटर में डाल देंगे। और अगर कैरी जनरेट होती है तो हम क्या करेंगे, सीधे पॉइंटर को इंक्रीमेंट करेंगे, काउंटर को डिक्रीमेंट करेंगे, और तब तक करते रहेंगे जब तक कि हमको वैल्यू मिल ना जाए, तो जब तक कि इसकी वैल्यू, सी की वैल्यू जीरो ना हो जाए। और ये प्रोसेस ये तब तक चलता रहेगा जब तक कि कैरी सी रजिस्टर की वैल्यू जीरो ना हो जाए, और जब जीरो हो जाएगी तो उस समय एक्यूमुलेटर में जो कुछ भी कंटेंट होगा दैट विल बी द स्मॉलेस्ट। लेट अस गो विद एन एग्जांपल। यू हैव टू चेंज दिस फ्लो चार्ट, इट इज द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ योर्स दैट यू चेंज दिस फ्लो चार्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू द लार्जेस्ट, इट दिस फ्लो चार्ट इज फॉर द लार्जेस्ट नंबर। यू हैव टू ड्रॉ अ फ्लो चार्ट फॉर द स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर। आई हैव नॉट ड्रॉन, आई हैव रिटन द सेम, बट दिस इज रॉन्ग, यू हैव टू चेंज इट। I will give in the assignment how to do it. So, first number is 56, and this 56 will be compared with FF. So it will be able to find that FF is greater than 56. So what will we do? There will not be a carry because accumulator is already having the largest number. So if it is not having the carry, so what we'll do? 56 will be copied in the accumulator, and then counter is decremented by one, and it will not zero, it will come back. Since INX has been done, so it will be loaded with the 2202. So now 2202 pair of content A9. Now A9 will be compared with 56. 56 is in the accumulator. So it is fine that 56 is smaller, so carry generate hoga. A carry generate hoga, so it will come to the INX. It means 56 is a smaller number. And then it will decrement INXH, it will load HL pair by 2203, and it will decrement the counter and it will go back. And now 2203 content, which is 73, is compared with 56. 56 is smaller, again carry will be generated. Again, it will increment the HL pair by 1, so it will become 2204. It will decrement the counter, it will become 1. And then it is compared. Now 82 is compared with 56. 56 is smaller, again the carry will be generated. So it will skip and it will come to INSH, it will become 2205. Decrement C, it will become zero. As soon as it becomes zero, whatever is the content of accumulator is 56, and that 56 will be copied at the 2300 to say that out of these four number, which is given 56, A9, 73, and 82, 56 is the smallest number.